Hey everybody, it's Michael Bovee. Thanks for tuning in to our YouTube channel, DebtBytes. Please like and subscribe if you enjoy what we share here. I'm gonna talk to you about a reader question that I get from time to time. It's not great that this happens, the misconceptions that you might see out there. So this is going to be in our busting myths section of our YouTube channel. And the question is like, hey Michael, if I pay what little I can afford to a debt, won't that stop collections? And the answer is no, it doesn't. Sometimes you find something on the internet or listen to somebody well-intended and their advice to you is to, well, look, you can't afford your $200 minimum payment on your Chase credit card, but just send them 20 bucks and that will keep it from going to collections, or that will keep them at bay. And actually, no, it doesn't. The only thing you can do with a lender in order to pay less than what you owe and have it actually be legit and stop that collection machine from rolling forward and grinding is reach an agreement with them directly. And guess what? In this case, Chase, we're picking on them. They do have plans that you can work with them. You have to call them, you have to talk to them and find out what you qualify for, and they can lower your monthly payment, sometimes temporarily and sometimes for the life of the balance, not to exceed 5 years. And we have other videos about hardship plans, which is mainly what that would be when you're talking to a credit card bank. But this applies to more than credit cards. People reach out and they ask about, well, listen, I have this huge bill and it's for medical debt, and I've been sending them $25 a month because they said, just send what you can. And I thought, well, that's what I can. And then next thing you know, they have a debt collector showing on their credit report 6 or 7 months later. And they thought, well, wait a minute, how does that work? They told me to do what I can. So it's not just well-intended people, it's actually the people that you owe are sometimes giving you this feedback. And we interpret it to mean like, well, then that's cool and that's gonna stop the train from rolling over me, right? No, not really. So going back to Chase, if you have that $200 minimum payment that you're supposed to pay on your $17,000 balance credit card that you own, and you don't send that in and you send 50 bucks instead for 1 month, you're gonna find shortly thereafter that you'll have a 30-day late pay on your credit report because you didn't have an agreement with Chase to send less. And now you didn't send the $200 that was required. Now you're getting a ding on your credit. Do that for 6 months and you've got six 30-day late pays, 30, 60, 90, 120, 150, and then now you've got a charge off on your credit report. And then Chase is gonna subject that account like normal, even though you sent them 50 bucks a month times six, $300, all that did was probably pay the $38 late fee, right? So it didn't even apply to the balance much, if at all. It just interest, unpaid interest, and you probably didn't even take a dent. You didn't move the balance down at all with that 50 bucks, and it did not stop them from sending your account out to debt collectors, which they're likely to do on your 7th month of delinquency. So it's myth busted here. And again, picking on Chase, you can apply this to virtually any kind of bank, any kind of personal loan, or any kind of contractual obligation that you have. Unless you have an agreement, and a very express agreement, like I said, calling Chase and getting on their hardship plan or whatnot, then this is actually a waste of money. So again, make sure to like and subscribe to our videos and our channel if you're enjoying what you're viewing here. We'll see you on the next video.